your hands together for our next performer tonight, Dwight Douglas. What's going on, Comedy on Broadway? Give me folks here, Comedy on Broadway, another round of applause. Scott. I think I see Aaron in there, a little bit out there in the lobby. Getting old sucks, don't it?
Yeah.
I'm a millennial. I'm not old, but I'm getting there. And see, we millennials, you know, we're a different breed. Rolled out of my bed the other day, see my boxes on the floor, right? And most guys in their teens and 20s, what do? When we see a garment or a boxer, what do? We go foot scoop, you fling it up and you catch it. I don't know why, because either we're mature or we're dumb as shit. One of the two. I did it on my birthday, the day I turned 29. My hip popped, my toes tingled, and my back spasmed up. I was so mad, I called in to work. I withdrew money out of my 401k. I took the penalty, I didn't give a shit. But that's the thing, is, you know, we're stubborn, and we don't even listen to our parents. They tell you, enjoy your youth, you know, cherish it, right? But we thought they were lying like they do everything else, right? They tell you about a rabbit that shits chocolate eggs. They tell you about a fairy that steals your teeth at night and gives you 25 cents in the end. What the hell am I going to do with 5 nickels? I'd rather have my baby teeth. I'll be 50 years old with little tiny baby teeth. I wouldn't give a shit. Take me 50 minutes to eat a Big Mac. I don't give a damn. Then they tell you about a fat white man who comes down your chimney every time Jesus has a birthday. Our parents, you gotta, you know, at least take that little bit of advice, okay? Because, you know, but we're stubborn. You know, if we take some of the habits we've developed in our teens and 20s into our 30s and 40s, we're in for a rude awakening, like these millennials pushing out their farts. Yeah, you take that habit into your 30s and 40s. You don't realize your sphincter ain't as tight as it used to be. It ain't as responsive. And once you do that, it's all downhill after that. It's going to be like Mount St. Helens blew all over again. And you better pray it's in public. Because you don't know nobody at Walmart, you know. If someone sees you coming out of the stalls with a pair of room skimmies, nobody knows the wiser. You can lie to them.
Yeah, I just found them on the floor. I just cleaned up and I figured, you know.
But if it's around friends and family, you never live it down. So what? Why don't Uncle Dwight never come to the Thanksgiving dinner anymore? Your uncle don't come to Thanksgiving anymore because your uncle had a serious case of the mud butts on Christmas Eve. Shit all over my couch. I ain't even paid it off yet. Well, he owes me a bill for Stanley Stevens, if you ever see his nasty ass. Anybody gone doing any shopping lately? I know it was Black Friday, but, you know, thought I'd make a pie or something, so I went down to the produce section. What the hell is going on in agricultural science? Foot-long bananas is what I'm talking about. I walked down there, they had a whole row full of foot-long bananas. I'm not putting a foot-long banana in my house. Hell, you know our guys are. There's not going to be no bananas in my house bigger than my banana. And my wife ain't need no banana either, foot-long. You give her a week or two coming in there with a normal size, you know, half a dozen bananas. And she's like, oh, I don't think I'm getting satisfied anymore. Bitch, give me a banana. You don't even need it. I just think I could do better. Look, you don't need no potassium, girl. Give me here. Yeah. And that's why I don't even get the regular oranges anymore. I get the little cuties. That's what I do. Not in my house. Yeah, I don't even get the grapes. I get the raisinets. That's my time. I don't think I think I might have gone over a little bit.
Dwight Douglas, everybody. Dwight Douglas! All right, you guys, give yourselves a round of applause for hanging in there with us tonight, all of you. Great, thank you. Thank you all. Thank you all. Also, I want to point somebody out tonight. Ted, where's Ted? Did Ted leave already?
Right there.
He's smoking.
He's out smoking because tomorrow he's got a heart cap.